Hey there, and welcome to my unboxing and review of the GlowFX Pixel Pro goggles. I have wanted for some time to upgrade my current goggles since they're not very cool looking in daylight and they also don't only have a static green light. I'm also not able to wear them with any of my LED masks due to the shape. So I was looking at the Pixel Pros. GlowFX do ship worldwide, but due to local custom taxes here in Europe, this wasn't really an option without ending up being really expensive. But after some time searching on Google for other alternatives, I found out that the Wave Cave, a company located in the UK that specializes in visual enhancement products for events and parties, was selling them. So I was able to buy them without ending up paying custom taxes since it was within the EU. The Wave Cave is exclusive distributor of GlowFX products in the UK and to my knowledge is the only within the EU. Okay, let's take a look at the package. So, seems like the Wave Cave included some gifts. There are some business cards with discount codes. Also a bracelet, and then there are free paper GlowFX diffractional glasses. You get those if you order for over £30. So nice that they were included, and some gifts. Okay, let's take a look at the package. So we have the goggles with the power bank attached. Then we have a user guide. And we have a USB charging cable, micro B. And the remote. There are three different versions of the glass: tinted, diffractional and kaleidoscope lenses. I bought the tinted glass. You only have the tinted glass option on the glass version. So if you want the diffractional or kaleidoscope lenses, then you need to go for the goggles. I bought the tinted version because I want to be able to move around freely and still be able to see where I'm going while wearing them. Also nice being able to use them as flashlight, but I will see if I can demonstrate that later. So that's nice if you want to find back to your camp in the middle of the night. The light features on the goggles and the glasses are the same. The viewing angle while wearing them is of course better on the glasses. You might not be able to see so much to the sides here with the goggles. But the reason why I ended up buying those is because that the power bank is attached to the glasses itself and not like the glasses version where you need to have them in your clothes with the power cord. You also have the adjustable straps here, so it will fit nicely on your head, so the knot will fall off when you're jumping around or jump up and down on your head. So there are 32 LEDs, 14 levels of brightness. They claim that the battery life will last between 5 and 7 hours, depending on the modes. I will test how long it will last with solid color mode and with animation, and then post that in later in the video. I will make a separate video where I will cycle through all the plus 350 modes, so you will be able to see all the options available. I will put a link in the video description for that video. Okay, so let's check it out. Let's see if we can get some power. So yeah, if we take a look at the remote, then we have the modes you can cycle through, up and down. Then you also have here on the side, you have two speed buttons, so you can turn it way down, or if you want it really fast. And then you just have the autoplay option. It will still remember the speed. Then you have the where you can add it to your favorites, so you don't have to cycle through all of them. Let's check the next one and add that as well. Then we can cycle through our two that we have added to favorites. You can also remove from favorites, so we only have this one. Then you also have the static color options. And here on the speed buttons, this is where you select the brightness. See if we can turn it down. So there's 14 levels here, and you will only be able to turn up and down the brightness when you are on static colors. When you are on the animation, then you have the speed options. So let's see if we can turn it all the way up. So it's actually pretty bright. Let's just see if I turn off the light, see what happens. Yeah, so they really light up. So I just did a battery test, and on solid color I was able to get 3.5 hours on default brightness, and on light mode I was able to get 4 hours. They got a little bit warm, but nothing uncomfortable, so that's nothing I would worry about. If you take breaks, then it will last longer, I think. So yeah, definitely okay. Could be better, but so if you have the possibility to have another power bank, that would be great. So this is just quickly to show you if you wanna try and use the goggles as flashlight. So you're definitely able to see where you're going. So I just returned from the Airbeat One Festival in Germany, and I had a blast with the glasses. They definitely got a lot of attention. I didn't see anyone else at the festival with these glasses, so if you want to stand out in the crowd, then this is definitely something you should consider to pick up for your next event that you're going to. The battery lasted all night, so taking a break definitely resulted in the power bank to last longer. So to conclude my review of the GlowFX Pixel Pro goggles, I think that they are worth the price, and I'm happy that I decided to upgrade from my old goggles to the Pixel Pros. So this is definitely something that I can recommend. I reached out to the Rave Cave, and they were happy to provide a discount code. So if you use my discount code SPADEN at next checkout, then you will get 10% off your next purchase. If you liked the video, then give it a like and subscribe for more videos like this in the future.